Hey guys, what is up? And it's been way too long at this point since I posted my original desk setup tour video, and some stuff has changed since then, so I wanted to bring you guys an updated one. So in this video, we're taking a look at my desk setup tour for late 2019. So right off the bat, you can probably tell that I try to keep just the extra stuff to a minimum. I like to keep just the absolute necessities on my desk because at the end of the day, this is where I want to get work done, and I don't want anything extra to waste time or just take up space if I don't need it to be there. And I feel like the best place to start with a desk setup like this is obviously the desk, because that's kind of like the basis of everything. And in this case, what I'm using is an IKEA tabletop. This is fully wood. I used to have an older IKEA desk that was made out of like fiberboard, but it just fell apart. It was very poor quality. And overall, it's just so much nicer having a solid wood desk. I've got it sitting on two of the IKEA Alex drawer units. The Alex drawer units are fantastic because it gives me tons of storage space. I can put all my cables in here, any peripherals, anything extra that I don't need on my desk, they can go in there. Now, starting with the things on top of the desk, I have my custom built PC over here, and you might not remember it, but this was actually also in my old desk setup tour video. Since then, not a ton has changed. I've actually, as I'm doing this video, I just purchased a graphics card upgrade, so I'm upgrading from the GTX 970 to a GTX 1070 Ti, so that's gonna be a pretty big upgrade, which will be nice because I've had this card for quite a while. Overall, the specs are getting a bit dated. Right now I'm running an i5-4460, which is still perfectly usable. I have no problems with it, but I feel like over time it has gotten a bit slower and doesn't perform quite as well in CPU intensive games. 16 gigabytes of RAM, a 256 gigabyte SSD, 1 terabyte of storage, pretty typical stuff there. And it also comes in an NZXT S340, which I feel like looks really nice, very clean sitting on my desk. Now moving over to the left, we've got the monitor, and really the monitor is one of the most important pieces of tech on here. I mean, at the end of the day, that's what you're looking at. So no matter how good your computer is, if you've got a terrible monitor, it's just really not gonna be a good experience. And that's why I'm using the BenQ EW3270U. This was actually sent out to me by BenQ, and I did quite a bit of testing. I have several other monitors that I've used, but I ended up switching to this one just because I like having the full 4K resolution. It's also fairly color accurate, even though it is a VA panel, so if you're not like right in the center of the display, the colors can shift a little bit, which can be a bit of a problem if I'm working on like work that needs to be color accurate. Overall though, it's not a problem if I'm facing directly at it. And it's got, like I said, it's got HDR support, 10-bit color support. It's pretty affordable. And just with that resolution, it's perfect for video editing. I can have multiple windows open and just take full advantage of that 32-inch display. Now, apart from that, your peripherals are also a very important part of any setup. And when I'm working at a desk, I like to have a nice keyboard and mouse to work with. So my choice for the keyboard currently is the Motospeed CK108. And this is a fully mechanical keyboard. It's using Atomo Blue switches, which are very similar to Cherry MX Blue switches. They are a little bit on the loud side personally, so I ended up actually purchasing a new keyboard right before I started this video. It's not here yet, but I ended up purchasing the AmPro 2 keyboard, which is a mechanical keyboard, but it uses Kale Brown switches, which are a little bit quieter, and I feel like it'll be a better choice for gaming and stuff like that. The main reason I purchased that keyboard though is because I do find it a little bit large for my desk. If I'm not using something, I don't really see any point in having it. And in this case, I don't really use the number pad arrow keys that much, so I felt like it was smarter to go with a 60% keyboard design. So I'm excited to try that keyboard out. Now moving over from the keyboard, I also have the Logitech G602 wireless gaming mouse. And basically that name tells you everything. This is a wireless mouse, and that's mainly the reason I purchased it. I don't mind having wired keyboards, but when it comes to mice, I really like having a wireless one. And overall, it's just been fantastic. I have no complaints with it. It's held up very well in the time I've had it, which has been quite a while, as with my keyboard. Battery life is absolutely amazing on this thing. It's super comfortable. It's got lots of programmable keys, really no complaints here. And overall, if you're looking for a cheap mouse or a cheap wireless gaming mouse, this is a fantastic option. Now moving over here to the left side, we've got my BenQ e-reading lamp. And Just like a good monitor or good keyboard, having a good lamp is a really important part of any setup. And I've been using this lamp long enough that I've been able to really test it out. And I gotta say, overall, I'm really happy with it. Using it on a desk setup like this is really the ideal use for this type of lamp, since its main focus is for reading and working at a computer. And when it comes to actually using it, it's activated with just a touch on this ring, and you can also fine tune brightness as well as color temperature with this knob right here. So that's great in case you're working late at night, you might want to have warmer light just to help a little bit with eye strain, or if you're working during the day, you can adjust it to have a cooler light. If you tap and hold on the power button or power ring, I guess, you can switch it to a mode that will actually detect the lighting of your environment and automatically set the brightness to a proper level. Now, I personally don't really use it that much just because I like choosing what level I want, but I can imagine that would be a great feature to have if you just want to set it and really not worry about adjusting the brightness. Now, if you're like me, what you probably notice right away when looking at this is that unique curved design, and that's actually there for a reason. That allows the lamp to illuminate a much wider range than your typical flat design, which I found helpful considering I have a fairly wide desk. Besides the range of the light, the quality is also really good, I found. BenQ states that it has what they call zero flicker technology, which is meant to obviously reduce any kind of flickering you get with the lighting, and it just produces a very clean and constant light. And while I can't like absolutely 100% test that, I can say it looks excellent to me with wide coverage and no glare to speak of when I'm using my computer, so overall I don't really have any complaints. In terms of build quality, I've used many lamps in the past, ranging from your cheaper ones to more higher end ones, but I've never used one that feels as solid as this. Like when I first picked this up, I kind of anticipated it would be pretty heavy just based on its size, you know, but this thing is way more solid than I expected. But while it's definitely in the higher end range of desk lamps, if that's what you're looking for, you're definitely not going to be disappointed. One thing I want to mention, if I had to choose one extra feature to add to this, if BenQ is listening, I would have to say it would be really nice to have like a USB port or some type of wireless charging feature added to the base, just to add a little bit of extra flexibility. Now before I move on, I would like to give a quick shout out to BenQ for sending this out for me to test out. And this video isn't sponsored or anything. I'll always make a point to tell you guys if I have a video that's sponsored, but I wanted to give this lamp a little bit of extra time since I have separately reviewed most of the other products mentioned in this setup video on my channel. So that's about it for all of the primary stuff I use on my desk. I also have this fake IKEA plant, which, let's be real, that's obviously the most important thing here. Not really, but still it's nice to have a little bit of color to add to an otherwise pretty plain setup. Also, I wanted to mention before I wrap it up, the stuff that you might not see just at first glance, and that's my cable management. Underneath my desk, I'm using an IKEA product basically to manage all of my cables, and I'll try to find that and link that in the description down below. That's about it, so hopefully you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.